Here I am, Geoff Carter, live from Chinatown in Bangkok. Now, I was just in Sukhumvit and I thought, right, I'll nip there on one of the little Tuk Tuks. I didn't think it was far. Anyway, he wanted 350. I went, no, you've no chance. I'll give you 200 back. Bloody hell, it was like wacky races. You've never seen anything go as fast. Anyway, it took about 20 minutes to get here. I didn't realise it was this far. But it's worth it, because look where we're going now. Ding, 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 ding. So come on, we're in Chinatown. Let's taste some of the delights. Let's have a look at some of the sights. And let's just have a fantastic night. Come on, let's go. This is what I've been looking for. There, look, see the sign? Soy 6, Yaorawat Road. And apparently down here, there's loads of really good street food. So come on, let's go. Everybody's selling all different stuff, from fruits to fish to duck, pork, seafood. Big flames going on down there. What's going on down there then? So this looks all right, doesn't it? All fresh seafood, look at this. Fish sizzling away there. Nice big fresh fish there for you. Them woks are red hot. Blimey. And there's the man cooking the food now. Wow. Flamage. They must have ordered very well done. How about that then? Okay, let's carry on. Getting hotter again. So what I've noticed so far in Chinatown, there's lots of like gold centres and things like that, but not many indoor restaurants that I can find at the moment. It all seems to be like nighttime street food. No thank you. I'm not joking, they're doing me head in these tuk-tuks every 5 minutes. Tuk 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 tuk, myva myva myva. You could see I was filming then, it just wanted to be on telly. Right, well I seem to come to the end of the big road now in Chinatown, and all I'm coming across at the moment is a lot of street food, some gold centres, but not really restaurants like you'd find in Chinatown in London or Manchester. You know, the ones where you go in, you can have some duck and pancakes and a bit of sweet and sour chicken and rice and all that caper. This seems to be street food. So I'm going to walk back down here. I might be on the wrong road. There might be a road with loads of restaurants. So I'm going to keep mooching. But no matter what happens, I'm going to have some food tonight. Just walking down this alleyway now. It's going to take me a few streets down. Now, I've been down here in the day. It's absolutely chock-a-block. You can't move. But obviously, they all finish at tea time. So hopefully, we'll find something down here where we can get some decent scran. Hope it's quick because I'm starving. Yeah, but this looks nice, look. In the middle of nowhere, look. Wow, that chili then just hit my throat. Let's carry on. Whoa, I've only just got lost again, haven't I? But it's nothing new for me, that, is it? That's all that's down here. Two paper lanterns. We'll have to just keep going. Will I ever get any Chinese food tonight? That's the question. We'll see. Wow, look at all that crispy duck. Looking a bit more favourable now. Look at them. Pig's heads. Wow, fantastic. Hello.
Hi.
How much of them, love?
40 baht.
40 baht? Yeah, which is the best one? The orange or that one?
One.
What's that one? Pomegranate.
Pomegranate.
And this one, nectarine. Okay, I have one of these. Thank you. Capcorn. Oh, I need this. Been walking around for about an hour. Wow. Dead fresh, dead cold. It's juice-alicious. Blimey, that didn't even touch the sides. Anyway, I found out around here, right? Because they're all like Chinese, mainly. They can't even speak any English. So when you ask them where's the indoor restaurants, they don't know. So I'm just going to have to keep searching. But I'm fancying at the moment now, and I can taste it on my taste buds, I'm fancying some crispy duck with pancakes, some oyster sauce and chopped cucumber, etc. So that's what I'm looking for now. I'm on the hunt for an indoor restaurant. Now, whether I'm going to find one, I don't know. Oh, it's hot out there. Tell you what, I've had to come in 7-Eleven, calm down. Now, the idea is if you're getting overeating and things, just come stand near the fridges here. Look. Oh, that's nice and cold, see? And then just get yourself a Coca-Cola. There you are. 14 baht, 28p. That last drink was 40 baht, 80 pence.
There we go, 7-Eleven or Family Mart.
Just come in, get yourself a cool drink, cool down while you're at it. Total disaster. No restaurants. Just going to sit outside on the street like I've been doing for the last month. I was hoping to finish my holiday off with a nice indoor crispy duck and some sweet and sour ribs or something. But at the moment, it looks like it could be just some fish like that and some morning glory outside where it's about 40 degrees. So, if you're planning on coming to Chinatown and think you're going to sit down and have a nice meal in some big plush seats, you know, out of velour and all that red wallpaper and all that caper, bit of Chinese music going on, some fortune cookies, some chopsticks and all that, not here. You're going to have to sit on the street with the rest of them and just have some street food. So that was Chinatown for you. Was it worth the trip all the way from Sukhumvit? Took about 20 minutes with Speedy Gonzalez in his Tuk Tuk. Wanted 350 baht. He got 200 baht in the end. Nice to walk around and have a little look, but I just wanted something a little bit different. So that's it from me so far. Geoff Carter checking in from Chinatown live in Bangkok. If I find a restaurant, I'll let you know. All right, see you in a bit. Well, that's it. I've walked up and down twice now, and everybody else doesn't know of any restaurants, but I found this one. It's called Chinatown Scala Restaurant. It's got a big kitchen there, so I think I'll go in there and see if they've got any duck. So I'm starving now. You know the score, don't you? All right, catch you in a bit. Right then, I was going to go in here, but shark's fin soup starts at £120. They do a small one here, starts at £6. You get a little slice, right? But a duck's £20. 1,000 Thailand baht, look. 1,000 Thailand baht. And that's £20. So, you know, 800, that's £16 for them. And crabs there, they're £16. And just have things like some fish here, £8 just for that small portion. So, I think we'll have a little walk, and it looks like I might have to eat some street food after all, after coming all this way on Wacky Races machine. Ah well, we'll see how we go, eh? Ah, look at that. Oh, at last I found one. It's called the Nam Sing Bird Nest and Shark Fin Restaurant. And the one next door, that was 1,000 baht for a duck. And you can have some duck here for 250 baht. That's only a fiver, isn't it? Or if you want the 500, it's only a tenner. So that's what I'm going to do here now. I'm going to plonk myself down here, have some nice food. It's nice and cool. And it's quite cheap as well. So I'll show you the food when it comes, okay? Well, it's turned up. There's the duck. There's the hoisin sauce. There's the spare ribs. But no pancakes. So it doesn't look like I'm going to get any, does he? But never mind. They speak Chinese. I speak English. Okay, boys? Shy. Hey, I'll tell you something. It might not be any pancakes, but look how tender that is. Lovely. Thank you. Great, eh? And two different dips, so I've got my duck at last. Fantastic. Aloy mat mat. Wow. Well, that was a rum shindig. Got in there, ordered that food. Duck, wanted the pancakes and all that caper. Come on, some crispy noodles, and then the spare ribs, they was with sweet and sour. Anyway, excuse me, moi, pourquoi, la fenêtre. I ate them, but they didn't even come from the kitchen upstairs. Arsenal! The two lads brought them in off the street, so I think they just got street food anyway. And I just ended up sitting in there, but it was alright, it was nice, it was tasty. And it only cost a tenner for everything, including drink, so that was it. So that's Chinatown for you. Stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe. Give us a thumbs up if you like it. All right, see you later. Ta-da.